Today we look at a new addition to the game. This, the most powerful without doubt, and what could be the most powerful weapon in the game overall. How's it going, guys? My name is DPG and today I'll bring you another Borderlands 3 video. If you do enjoy it, leaving a like really helps me out, and subscribe if you want to see more. On screen now you can see my weekly giveaway along with last week's winner. To be in with a chance of winning this yourself, follow the instructions on screen now and good luck. Okay, so today we check out the Iron Cannon. This heavy weapon, this beast, this absolute monster. Fun detected, obliterate. Now this weapon comes in many variants. I was first sent this one by my pal, Avro99, and then I had a few drop myself. This one you can see on screen now offers cryo with 16,425 times 2 damage. Like what? But you know what people, they actually get higher than this. We have 72% handling, a 4.2 second reload time, a 1.82 fire rate, and a magazine size of 14. Other benefits, plus 450% weapon damage, plus 15% weapon fire rate, plus 281 splash damage radius, consumes 2 ammo per shot, and has a 2x2 zoom. Now this weapon is just an absolute brute, people. And on screen there you can see the many other variants I actually have, along with a couple others my pal Avro Arrow sent me. Now what's great about this is I'm absolutely certain it's a guaranteed drop from, I believe, a boss who is super simple to farm. Now as it's early days, where this is obtained I will tell you guys in a minute with plenty of spoiler warnings. But let's check out what this thing is actually capable of, because in all honesty, so many weapons look great on paper, but when it actually comes to performing, they fall below par. So what I expected was a weapon which basically obliterated all with minimum inputs from builds and so forth. As when it comes to testing such weapons, I don't want builds interrupting true stats. And to be honest guys, this for what it does, for sure lays down that damage. There is no two which ways about it. And it just makes me wonder what this thing would be capable of with certain damage builds or DPS build setups. I think we could see a weapon capable of one hitting most things in this game. Now this version offering cryo, I being a Zane main, I could go ahead and rebuild my Sub-Zero class and really make the most out of this weapon and see its true potential. Now I will be honest with you guys, I rarely, and I mean rarely, ever use any kind of heavy weapon. I honestly feel for the most part they take up space for the little damage they can cause. Not for the fact that they are not powerful, because for the most part they are really powerful, the most powerful in most cases. It's just the fact of the time it takes for them to actually lay down that damage. BL3 for me is about killing things quick, and it's on that basis I like to build and play. Heavy weapons don't really suit that for me. This one though changes that. It's a heavy weapon which deals unreal damage and is actually efficient in laying down damage quite quickly. And it's balanced out with a decent clip size too, which we can only approve upon within our builds. So yes people, the Iron Cannon is definitely one you should be trying to land a decent variant of, because the damage this thing is capable of is off the charts. Here's my pal hitting a million damage on flak with the thing, nothing special within his loadout either, just using fade away. So spoiler warning, although it isn't that bad of a spoiler and it won't spoil much, it's coming. So if you don't want to know how this is obtained, as it's alongside someone or something within the story, turn off now. Okay, so this heavy, the Iron Cannon, I believe is a guaranteed drop from the Fabricator Mark II boss, who is towards the end of this DLC's campaign. And the location of this boss you can see on screen now. He is within Jack's secret area on the Handsome Jackpot. So follow the route I take on screen now to this dude who was dropping this for me every single time I ran him. So good luck in getting that roll, people. But yes, this has been the Iron Cannon. I have been DPJ. I hope you enjoyed the video. This, in my opinion, is definitely a weapon you should be seeking out. It's a heavy weapon I will be keeping within my loadout. And I may just build. Actually, I may just go back, farm this boss a few more times and see what else I can land myself. I mean, I ain't really a massive fan of Zane's Sub-Zero build. I like to experiment with other things. So maybe I could just find one that matches that. That'd be perfect for me. But on that note, guys, we have come to the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more Borderlands videos, be sure to subscribe. And if you never want to miss a video I upload, you can turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and hopefully I will see you on that next one.
Same deal.